Warm greetings to all. In this session, I would like to discuss about sustainability in supply chain, the learning objectives. To understand the importance of sustainability in supply chain, describe the framework for evaluating sustainability and to discuss ways and means of enhancing sustainability in the supply chain. At the end of the session, the learners would be able to appreciate the need for sustainability in supply chain, comprehend the dimensions of sustainability in the supply chain, understand means of achieving sustainability in supply chain. In this video, we will discuss supply chain sustainability, its significance, factors affecting sustainable supply chains, along with a caselet. Well, dear learners, I'm sure all of you are aware of what a supply chain is. Let's consider a bottle of Pepsi that we consume. How does that reach us? There are lot of activities in the whole process, such as procurement of raw materials, such as sparkling water, cane sugar, caramel, apple extracts, natural plant extracts, and so on. Then processing the same in manufacturing unit, storage, transporting and distribution of the same to end consumers. All these activities involved in moving the raw material to the end consumers as finished goods are termed as supply chain. We know that all these activities consume a lot of natural resources such as energy, raw materials and alike, which are limited. Further, each process gives out a lot of waste in the process, such as carbon emissions, solid and liquid waste. Here comes the need for sustainability. An organization which connects the suppliers and end consumers does not exist on its own. It's a part of the whole world and is bound to be responsible to society. An organization takes a lot of inputs from nature and society and delivers output back to the society. Therefore, the organization has to be responsible for designing and implementing what is called a sustainable supply chain. Having seen the significance, let us now see what exactly is supply chain sustainability. Well, supply chain sustainability is a holistic view of supply chain processes and activities that addresses the environment, social, economic, and legal aspects thoroughly. Today, organizations not only strive towards profitability, but also they struggle to meet sustainability norms. Therefore, sustainability in the supply chain is more a strategic approach which has to align with an organization's goals, planning, and implementation. A sustainable supply chain demonstrates a long-term commitment to the procurement and supply chain management that considers the environmental, social, and economic consequences of design, non-renewable material use, manufacture and production methods, logistics, service delivery, use, operation, maintenance, reuse, recycling options, disposal, and suppliers' capabilities to address these consequences throughout the supply chain. This definition has been given by the Department for Environment, Food and Rural Affairs 2006. The major driving forces towards supply chain sustainability are: number 1, improving profits and to reduce risk; number 2, government mandates and community pressures; and finally, attracting new generation customers who value sustainability. Now, let's move on to the factors affecting supply chain sustainability. They are waste from various processes, carbon footprint and emissions, air pollutants, water pollution, safety violations, deforestation, non-degradable packaging, and labor law violations. Having seen The meaning of supply chain sustainability. Let us discuss a real case example of a company that has moved way ahead in its sustainability efforts. IKEA is one of the world's largest home furnishing retailer with more than 411 locations across 49 countries, and it has sincerely committed to planet and people. Following are some of the sustainability initiatives at IKEA. IKEA's products, including packaging, are made from renewable or recycled products. IKEA uses few materials for making the products without any compromise on quality or durability, thereby saving cost. IKEA has introduced a code of conduct for its suppliers, namely IWAY, that is IKEA way of purchasing home furnishing products, which has accounted for positive impact on environment way beyond compliance. IKEA almost produces 1/3 of their total energy consumption through renewable energy sources such as solar power, energy from windmills and biomass. IKEA strictly restricts child labor in its supply chain. It has also banned PVC in their products and lead from mirrors. IKEA has moved from incandescent bulbs to energy efficient LED bulbs in all their stores. IKEA sources raw materials such as wood and cotton from certified sustainable sources. IKEA collects point of sale data regarding sales, ideas and smart solutions. IKEA has reduced transportation related carbon emissions significantly by switching to electric vehicles. IKEA uses cost per touch inventory approach, which means the more hands that touch a product in the supply chain, the higher will be the cost. Customers select their items, pick them in the warehouse and go home. Thus, IKEA saves on shipping and delivery cost. Besides cost per touch, IKEA follows the Max/Min replenishment system for its product reordering. For all the products, two factors are set: the minimum amount of products available before reordering and the maximum amount of a product to order at one time. At IKEA, the max/min levels are usually set by the stock needed for one day. All IKEA locations have an in-store logistics manager. The in-house logistics managers collect the point of sale data regarding sales using the central inventory management software. The inventory system at IKEA also notifies deviations if any. IKEA further uses separate high flow and low flow warehouse facilities very efficiently. In high flow warehouses, high demand products are stocked and the storage and retrieval processes are highly automated in high flow warehouses. Low flow warehouse facilities, products that have low demand are stocked in low flow warehouses where the processes are manual. These sustainability strategies have given competitive advantage for the retailer IKEA, and it is highly successful with low operating cost and high product demand. To conclude, we have discussed what supply chain sustainability is all about, along with its significance, the factors affecting sustainability of the supply chain. In the next lesson, we will discuss on the framework for evaluating sustainability in supply chain. Thank you.